taking a thumbnail picture. Don't mind me. Didn't even know MC Hammer made the song. I am clearly not cultured because I thought this was like an Instagram famous song. I had no idea it was MC Hammer. Welcome to another juicy episode of OK Key. If this is your first time here, welcome to the fam. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed already. I create lifestyle videos for the everyday millennial who wants to live a joyous and well life. There are so much more videos and so much things that I have in store. So if you would like to stay abreast of them and be a part of the fam and stay a part of the fam, please subscribe. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram at OKKey because there's a good time over there too. And there's a lot of fun stuff happening. Okay, cool. Let's get into the video. Today, I am going to talk to the camera. I have told you guys before in this YouTube building thing that I'm doing, I do not know how to talk to a camera. It is the weirdest thing ever. But I'm trying to become more comfortable so that when I'm in, you know, Walmart or Target and I need to say something to the camera, or I need to create a vlog or something, that I'm not like awkward. So I'm trying to be a lot more comfortable with talking on the camera. So today that's what we're gonna be doing. And we're going to be talking about beginner's blues and me just wanting to quit this entire thing. Probably every day that I've been doing it, but here I am making a video. So obviously I haven't really quit yet, but I just want to be transparent and tell you guys my experience with doing YouTube, with trying to do Instagram, with doing a blog, all in 2021. It's a lot. Have my tea, have my cup of tea here. I have my pointer so that I can point out points. And I have my notebook filled with notes and stuff that I was writing down to help me stay on track for this video. Beginner's blues to me is when you begin a project, you have an idea, or you just begin something new, and you have like all this excitement in the beginning, and you're like, oh, I'm gonna do this, and oh, I'm gonna do that. But then after a while, maybe like after a month or two, when you're not seeing the momentum, and you're not seeing like the impact that you wanted to make, you start to get blue. And you start to feel like, is this even something that I'm supposed to be doing? Is this for me? And so that's kind of what I'm experiencing right now. In the social media space in general, I'm just experiencing a lot of blues. And even though I have people who support me, and I have people who watch my videos, read my blogs, and support me on Instagram, I also find myself looking at YouTubers and people who have been doing this for years, wondering why me in June 2021 is not where this person who started in 2015 is. It's a weird conundrum, and I don't know how the algorithm works in my head, but whatever. That's what beginner's blues is to me, and that's what I kind of want to talk about, and just talk about how to overcome it. And you know, if you guys have any suggestions on how I can overcome it, please put it in the comments. Help me out. I have been watching YouTube videos about how to not quit and why you shouldn't quit YouTube and why you shouldn't quit your creative journey. And although these videos have been very inspirational and have been very helpful with me like continuing to keep going, in the back of my mind, I'm just like, this is a lot. Like, it's a lot of work.
It's just a lot of sweat, tears, blood.
It ain't all that. I'm just kidding. It's not all that. But it is a lot of mental work. Not to say that I don't want to put in the mental work, because obviously you have to put in the work to make any type of impact and to get anywhere. So I'm definitely getting into the routine of putting in the work. But it does get discouraging when you edit a video and you record a video, but you only got like 3 views. And you're like, okay, hey, 3 friends, we love you and I love you and I thank you for watching my videos. But it's like, man, this is a bomb video. This is a bomb picture. At least I think it is. Maybe what I think is bomb is not what the world thinks is bomb. And that really could be a valid thing. But that's either here nor there. I create this bomb stuff in my mind, and I'm not reaching the masses. And I don't know if it's because people just don't see me yet. Maybe YouTube has not, you know, pushed my videos out there to people to see yet. Maybe Instagram doesn't really know who OKKey is. So they're gonna take their time and they're gonna push my stuff out to other people, which is fine. And I get it, and it makes sense because I am still growing and I don't wanna put out trash work for the masses to see. So if my work right now is on level 2 and people are used to a level 72, I don't wanna skip 70 levels just because I wanna be seen on a platform. You know, that's not really fair. So while I have these beginner blues, I also am like, you know, realistic. Like I started yesterday, not literally yesterday, but I started like yesterday, let's just say yesterday. I didn't start, you know, last week like a lot of people. A lot of people already knew, hey, let me get into the YouTube space. Let me get into the Instagram space. And they jumped in at a different time, at a time where it wasn't so many people trying to do it. And so that's not my story. I am jumping in when everybody and their grandma wants to do it, which is fine. And there's space for everybody, because even little me, I follow a lot of people on Instagram and a lot of people on YouTube because everyone's video and everyone's content speaks to me differently. So it's, you know, I don't follow one person and that's my go-to be-all one person for the stuff that I need or for the things that I'm trying to learn. I go to different people. So even though everyone and their grandfather and their grandmother and their auntie and their mom, everybody has a platform, everybody is for somebody, right? Just like I am for somebody. I may not be for some, but I am for somebody. You see what I did there? Y'all see it? Yeah, that's a point. I may not be for some, but I am for somebody. And if I am for you, that's dope, because I'm even trying to be for me. You feel me? Like, but anyway, a part of beginner's blues is the lack of support that you get from people. I am in the headspace or in the season where I am trying to let go of the fact that my family and friends do not have to support me. If they don't support me, it's okay. Like, it's not a big deal. And at first I felt like, oh, my family has to support me. Everyone has to share my YouTube videos and everyone has to be a part of it. No, they don't. No, they don't. And I'm getting into that mentality. And a part of the beginner's blues, like I said, for me is just accepting the fact that they're not going to support and they don't have to. And I'm going to love them if they do and I'm going to love them if they don't. And I don't want to get to a place where I'm taking it personally because my mom's not sharing my videos with her coworkers. Her coworkers are not my audience. I don't want to talk to her coworkers. So I'm actually very grateful that my mom didn't, you know, share my videos on her Facebook page, because those, I mean, that's not my crowd. Even though I have the beginner's blues and I want to quit and I want to give up, I know that my audience is out there. If I quit today, then I will never get to see, or I will never experience when my audience actually does find me and when my audience vibes with me and they come along the journey with me. So that's one of the reasons why I haven't quit yet, because I know that there are people out here that I have the influence to impact at some point. I know that there's people out here that I can be reaching. So yeah, tea break. You need a tea break. That's one. So if you're a beginner and you having these blues as well, get you a tea break. It'll change your perspective. Okay, back to it. In the beginning of this video, I started talking about how I was watching different YouTubers who express not to quit and express their desire to quit, but why they didn't, and because they didn't, they saw the fruits of their labor. And I would watch those videos and I would get so inspired, and I was like, you know what? Such and such started like this. It's okay. This is normal. I am not alone. Like, I should not feel as though I am on an island by myself, because most people in the creative space, they experience beginner blues. They experience the, you know, the highs and lows of, okay, people are supporting you one day and not supporting you the next day. They experience the highs and lows of, oh, I'm creative today, but I don't have anything to talk about tomorrow. So it's a normal thing. While I'm watching these videos, and I'm also watching videos of YouTubers that I've been watching for years and that have influenced me for years, I start to experience a lot of imposter syndrome. And I start to think, am I really fit for this space? Like, do I have the personality to be on YouTube? Do I have the personality and the looks to be on Instagram? Because we know that Instagram is a visual platform. People want to see your sexiness, not your sexiness really, but people want to see that you look good and they want to see your best. A lot of people highlight their best on Instagram. And while it becomes superficial after a while, and you should definitely highlight, like, you know, be vulnerable and highlight just your life in general, if that's like, you know, the thing you want to do or whatever. I just feel like sometimes I have that imposter syndrome moment where I wonder if I can be like such and such. That's something that I'm really learning to not do. I cannot be an imposter if I'm myself. That's a point. I cannot be an imposter if I am myself, you know, unless myself is an imposter, which I know I'm not. Like, I'm as nappy as they come, you feel me? Like, I'm as regular as they are. I got ash on my elbow too, you feel like I'm, yeah. Imposter syndrome shouldn't even be a thing. And it unfortunately is a thing when you are beginning a journey and beginning an idea, because for some reason, this, you know, cloud of doubt that you belong there, like, surfaces in your mind. But in reality, just like such and such belonged there in 2013, you know, such and such belongs there in 2021, I also belong there, because why not? You know, like, why not? Why wouldn't I? So yeah. How I plan on moving on. I have all of this built up creativity in me. I have all of these ideas in me. I have all these things that I want to do, all these things that I feel like make sense. Like I said, this is a building journey for me. So even speaking to you all right now is it's a stepping stone for me. I am being vulnerable with my journey. I'm trying to be as vulnerable as I can. There's a lot of things, like I said, that I want to do. Like, I'm thinking of, I'm on a weight loss journey, even though it looks like I'm, you know, small, that's cute, whatever, but I would like to be healthy. So I'm not gonna say a weight loss journey. I am on a healthy living journey. I want to eat better, and I want to get rid of some of the fat that I have on my body. Let's be real, okay? I want to, you know, show my weight loss journey, my health journey, my experience in adulthood journey. I want to share these things with you guys. I said all that to say, I am in the beginning stages, but in a couple of years, if I stay consistent, I want to come back to this video and say, Key, you stuck with it. Key, you did it. Key, you made a point. I want to come back to these videos and be really proud of the fact that I didn't stop. And I'm hoping that you guys, as I say in every video, and I'm going to say it in this video too, because I love that you guys watch my videos and you are on this journey with me. And if you are here to grow and to be and to whatever, put it in the comments. Let me know any advice you have for these beginner's blues, any advice you have for me as a creative. If you are a creative and you've experienced wanting to quit and wanting to give up on your YouTube, blog, Instagram, social media, creative journey, whatever journey, career journey, health journey, whatever it is that you feel like you've had struggles in, please let me know in the comments and let me know how you fought through those beginner's blues. What were some of the ways that you disciplined yourself? Anything that you guys can feed into me will help me to feed back out. I appreciate your feedback and I appreciate your help. I've come to the conclusion that it is normal to have beginner's blues. It is normal to want to quit a thing that you are not used to and that you are not knowledgeable about. It's also normal to want to quit things that you are knowledgeable about and you are used to. Maybe you feel like you need to move on. But if you are in the same place that I'm in regards to I'm just starting out and I'm just trying to figure out where I fit, please keep going with me. We are fit for this space. This space is huge enough for all of us. It's huge enough for you. It's huge enough for me. And whether we like it or not, we're making an impact and we are influencing somebody. So let's do the thing, okay? Let's do the thing, okay? Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you like content like this, let me know in the comments too. I'm asking y'all to let me know everything in the comments. I just want y'all to talk back to me. Let me know how you feel. If you don't like content like this, let me know. If you love it, let me know. If whatever, I just want y'all to talk to me. I want to feel like I'm not used to talking to a camera. So I want to feel like I'm talking to you, like in real life, okay? Don't forget to subscribe. If this was your first time here, welcome. I hope to see you again, and I hope that you come back. Please remember to follow me at OKKey on Instagram. I am trying to maintain a posting schedule of every Friday. So check my channel for another video next Friday, because I'm trying to stay consistent. Thank you for coming. I love you guys. You're the best. Don't forget to drink your tea and take your vitamins, okay? Okay. Bye.